Welcome to the Infowars Nightly News. I'm your host, Jakari Jackson. It's August 3rd, 2015, and here's a look at our top stories.
Tonight on the Infowars Nightly News. Could the Democrats' next presidential candidate, Joe Biden, signal an intensifying drug war against the American population? Windows' latest release opens the door to the expanding spy state right under your nose. And Alex Jones continues his investigation into the falling European economy.
I know you already know all this, but we need to get the word out to the general public because they're starting to wake up that there's a problem. They don't know what the solution is, and they're being sold that socialism and more collectivism and more wealth redistribution is the answer, not understanding the ultra, ultra, ultra rich are tax exempt.
All this and more on the Infowars Nightly News.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. I believe our research is conclusive. This is the best iodine out there. And I know this for a fact. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off super detox special at InfowarsLife.com.
Coming up later in our show, we'll have a special report from Alex Jones and also Rob Dew. They're over there in Europe. But first, let's talk about Prohibition. You guys have probably seen the old movies with the documentaries about the gangsters, the moonshiners, these guys cooking the bathtub brew, and then they go out in the streets and they have these big shootouts. It was a horrible, violent time in American history. And eventually, people decided that alcohol prohibition probably wasn't the best idea. But the thing about it is, so many years later, we have repeated the same cycle where you see people cooking meth in their bathtubs or in their basements, or you see these shootouts, these horrible gangland-style massacres in places like Chicago. It's pretty much the same thing that happened way back when, but now that we call it the drug war, it's something that we can't drop, and it continues to happen to this day. Now, should we legalize drugs across the board? I'm not telling anybody to go shoot up heroin or take meth or anything like that, but things such as marijuana, I wouldn't so much have an issue with. But now we have this article from Kurt Nimmo, Joe Biden, the drug war presidential candidate. According to Politico, Biden is a beloved figure in the Democratic Party, a stand-up guy, and the Democrats want him in the wings if for some reason Clinton implodes. Biden has enabled the disastrous drug war and played a key role in militarizing law enforcement, including mandatory minimum sentences and the creation of a cabinet-level drug czar. So for all the reasons that I previously mentioned, we have this huge disastrous drug war. You know, when you talk about these guys bringing in the cocaine and all this, and they want to lock up some guys like Rick Ross, who definitely was guilty, but it comes to common sense. Rick Ross wasn't born rich. He couldn't afford planes and trains and automobiles to bring all this cocaine in, so how did it get here? Nobody wants to talk about that. And they talk about, oh, you talk about Gary Webb, that conspiracy theorist. Regardless of what happened to a Gary Webb, and I definitely respect his reporting, if you don't trust a word that Gary Webb had to say, you can go see the 60-minute report where Mike Wallace was talking to the head of the DEA, and Mike Wallace said, hold on, you're telling me that the CIA brought cocaine to this country? And the DEA guy's like, yeah, I don't know any other way to tell you, Mike. This stuff is going on. It's continuing to happen in this country, and this is why they have to have these, or why they say to you that they need these MRAPs and the assault rifles and the riot gear and all this stuff. And yes, there is a time and place. There are situations where you may need riot gear where a standard cruiser or a van may not be sufficient. But to have this stuff across the board, it definitely is not necessary. And let's talk about things that aren't necessary in the spin cycle. Planned Parenthood. You guys have probably seen these several videos that have come out over the past few weeks. Planned Parenthood has the organization which targeting Planned Parenthood has a total of 9 videos. I think they're on video 4 or 5 right now. And in the most bizarre turn of events, I just can't believe they're going this route. They're saying that Planned Parenthood actually prevents abortions now. And now we have the spin cycle. We have the tweets from Planned Parenthood Republicans. And they're talking about how Republicans hate abortion, and they're trying to destroy a government program that helps prevent over 345,000 abortions a year. And anybody with any common sense points out that an organization claims it is preventing abortions while executing almost 400,000 abortions in 2013. So I'm very curious of how they even got this number, this 345,000 number, because how do you really know how many abortions you prevented? I mean, does somebody who come in there and, you know, get a bag of condoms come back and say, hey, I would have had an abortion if, you know, you didn't give me that that bag of condoms? I'm not exactly sure how they tabulate this, but I think it's just another load of bull. They're trying to ban these videos in states like California, saying that you don't have a First Amendment right as a news organization to even present this to your viewing audience. It's completely ridiculous, and I think that it's just a matter of time for Planned Parenthood. And when we're talking about a matter of time, it's time to fight for your privacy, because whether it's Edward Snowden or any other whistleblower, they're telling you that your privacy is at stake. And you may not care that, you know, people see your selfies or whatever until it's used against you in some type of way. And now we have Windows, they're spying on people. And the headline, "Don't Spy on Me, How to Opt Out of Windows 10 Intrusive Defaults." Windows 10's pre-installed settings are privacy intrusive by default. "We will access, disclose, and preserve personal data, including your content such as emails and other private messages, when we have a good faith belief that doing so is necessary," and that is according to the privacy statement. And they do have a few tips for trying to combat this. If you take a look at the article, it has a few tips on there. Disable sharing of your internet connection over Wi-Fi, as well as many other things. But it's not just on your devices, your big computers and all this, it's also on your phone. And how to combat this, we have a From the Vault report from Joe Biggs.
I'm Joe Biggs with Infowars.com. Now, here at Infowars, we try to keep you, the viewer, and the people all around the world awake to the information going on. You know, over the past few years, Alex Jones has repeatedly told you and others here at Infowars that the NSA is collecting your data. We have actual proof via my phone, my user agreement, where it says the NSA is taking my data and they're not responsible for any loss of data from my phone. This is mind-blowing. I mean, like I said, we've known about it, but just to see it on your own personal phone that you went and bought at an AT&T store, just me buying this makes me agree to them spying on me. Just think about that. That's crazy. Not until you open up your own phone and put in your, you know, your little password, you go to settings, and it's right there. I mean, I was just like, wow. So it's not that hard. You put in your password, and then I don't know how it is for Apple, but I have a Samsung Galaxy. All right, so you get your Android device, wherever your settings button is, click on that settings button, go to General, scroll all the way down to the bottom to wherever it says About Device. Then you're going to go to Legal Information, Open Sources, Licenses. Wait on that to load because there's quite a bit of information. You're going to go way down because that's how the NSA gets you. They want to hide the stuff way at the bottom. Okay, we're getting ready to come up on it. Here it is. All right, so system, lib/libselinux.so. Now we'll click on that. It says you agree that this software is a non-commercially developed program that may contain bugs, and the NSA makes no and hereby expressly disclaims all warranties. It also goes on to says that the NSA will not be liable for any loss of profits or loss of data on your phone. Now what that is the NSA is using Linux to access your information on your phone. So this is something that they even have a Wikipedia about. It is the Linux SE NSA spying program type deal. It's been available since 2003. So pretty much every phone since 2003 has been a spying tool for these NSA agents. Just think about that. Every phone you've had since 2003, the things you've done, seen, talked about, pictures you've shared, pictures you've taken. No wonder these celebrity, you know, nude pictures are coming up, because they're just out there. Anyone can get it. They don't need to steal your phone anymore. That's child's play. They can just go in through these bugs and it's right there. Proof. The NSA is spying on your phone. 2014 is 1984. Orwell was right. This handheld telescreen is spying on us right now and also giving us radiation while it sits in our pocket. So there you have it. I'm Joe Biggs with Infowars.com.
To some international news now. We're going to talk about Syria, and we have a report. U.S.-led strikes in Iraq and Syria killed hundreds of civilians, something we've been telling you all along. U.S.-led airstrikes targeting the Islamic State group in Iraq and Syria have likely killed at least 459 civilians over the past year, a report by an independent monitoring group said Monday. The coalition had no immediate comment. I'm sure they don't. And we see these reports from the Obama administration. Well, those numbers are too high. Well, I'm pretty sure your numbers are a little bit too low. They don't really want to tell you how many people they've actually killed, just like they reluctantly admitted that they killed people in the first place. At first, these things were just the most scientifically advanced, can't make a mistake. And then when the reports came out that they're blowing up wedding parties and blowing little kids' faces off, well, okay, yeah, we've undoubtedly killed a few people. And then he came out and admitted, oh, U.S., we tortured a few people. We've tortured a few folks, I think was the quote that he had. So these things do happen, and people don't care until it comes home to them, just like people didn't care about depleted uranium in these other foreign countries until our troops started coming home with the depleted uranium diseases and making sick children and all this. So you need to care about this stuff before it affects you in some type of negative way. And another thing, talking about Obama here, you guys recall when Obama went to Africa and said that Africans shouldn't have air conditioning because the planet would boil over because of global warming. Now we have Obama will emit over 300,000 pounds of CO2 jet-setting to Arctic to warn about global warming. So this is what's going on. You know, he's hanging out with Bill Nye, the science guy. They're taking selfies on Air Force One and telling you, and I took this very personally from Bill Nye, the science guy, that the reason why we have floods and tornadoes in Oklahoma is because of global warming. Bill Nye, the science guy, as smart as you are, there have always been floods and tornadoes in the state of Oklahoma. Golly, made me want to cuss there. Now, I'm going to end on a very sad note. We lost a great info warrior this past weekend, Rowdy Roddy Piper, the wrestler, the entertainer, the patriot. This guy, he came out, he used his celebrity in a very positive way. I've seen him in a commercial just recently talking about how we need to stop bullying campaigns and all types of other things. He's very well known for his role in They Live, a movie that woke a lot of people up. And when I'm talking about waking people up, take a look at this and see for yourself. We'll come back after this with more special reports.
I feel like this all the time, trying to politically awaken people that they're being lied to, that there's an agenda. It's not left or right. It's, hey, there's mind control going on. The signals broadcast 24 hours a day through all this media. Just become aware of it, and they'll say, there's nothing going on. And I want to say, put on these glasses or start chewing concrete.
They have taken the hearts and minds of our leaders. They have recruited the rich and the powerful. And they have blinded us to the truth.
The question is, do we all work for central bankers? That's what I want to address to our guest tonight.
Our impulses are being redirected. We are living in an artificially induced state of consciousness that resembles sleep.
An estimated 50 to 70 million Americans suffer from a sleep disorder or sleep deprivation.
Outside the limit of our sight, feeding off us, perched on top of us from birth to death, are our owners.
Latest census numbers prove the United States has the biggest gap between rich and poor compared to all westernized countries today.
Our projections show that by the year 2025, not only America, but the entire planet will be under the protection and the dominion of this power alliance. The gains have been substantial, both for ourselves and for you, the human power elite.
And for the first time in all of human history, mankind is politically awakened. That's a total new reality.
I've got one that can see.
We can't be the only ones who can see.
Unfortunately, you've grown up hearing voices that incessantly warn of government as nothing more than some separate, sinister entity that's got at the root of all our problems.
It's a new morning in America. Fresh, vital. The old cynicism is gone. We have faith in our leaders. We're optimistic as to what becomes of it all. It really boils down to our ability to accept. We don't need pessimism.
I have two words for you. Predator drones.
And who are you, little fella?
You will never see it coming.
Now predicting the first guy who uses a Second Amendment weapon to bring a drone down that's been hovering over his house is going to be a folk hero in this country.
Nice.
There is a signal broadcast every second of every day through our television sets.
I'm just trying to warn you folks, the television is a giant LED weapon system. It's so advanced. They got a monkey farm in Bastrop, folks. They do all sorts of testing on great apes, rhesus monkeys, the whole nine yards. And they go, oh, you didn't see this, and punch a button, and it'd be hundreds of monkeys with wires in their brains with television sets brainwashing them.
All I ever have to do is be famous. People watch me. And they love me.
You can have a little taste of that good life, too. Now, I know you want it. Hell, everybody does.
Do it to your own kind.
What's the threat? We all sell out every day. Might as well be on the winning team.
The real men of the world have to stand up and say,
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass.
And I'm all out of bubblegum. Time to take a stand, boys. You know what? You got a little courage. Stand up for yourself.
Waging war on corruption. It's Alex Jones coming to you live from the front lines.
It was almost as if it were a planned implosion. It just pancaked.
Well, pancaking almost like a precision implosion.
Reminiscent of those pictures we've all seen too much on television before, when a building was deliberately destroyed by well-placed dynamite to knock it down.
All non-essential personnel, move away from that collapse.
Brain Force is here. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been on this the last few months. You probably noticed I've been more crazed, more focused, less brain fog, more energy, more special reports, and it's because of Brain Force.
We kept changing this formula over and over and over again until it became sort of a grand puzzle. For example, the L-theanine inside of it, that is activated by the different compounds in the yerba mate that we put inside of it as well. This just increases the compounds you already have.
This is what you're actually designed to run on.
Exactly.
It's kind of like a car will run on one form of junkie gas, but it runs really good on what it's designed for.
And that's the principle of InfoWars life, as far as I understand, that you've always had, is that it's not about synthetic chemicals and forcing actions. It's about letting your body do its own thing and giving your body the tools it needs to create these different compounds that are super valuable and super beneficial.
You will find Brain Force and other game-changing products at InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139. I wanted to bring Weldon Henson in here briefly, because we have a great sponsor. Boy, I've sure been enjoying the firearms that I've gotten from them. HDfirearms.com. That's Head Down Firearms. They have super high quality 223s, 308, you name it. It's called 556, technically, in the 223, that are guns that would be $3,000 or $1,500. Guns that would be $1,500 or $900.
Well, the important thing to remember is that if you're not in the market to buy a brand new rifle, you have an AR-15, you have an AR-10 platform, 308 rifle. They've got everything you need to upgrade it. Buy a new part, buy a new trigger, buy a new muzzle brake, buy a new handrail. It's all an upgrade for your rifle, because these are all superior top-of-the-line quality products made in America.
Tell folks about their low-profile series.
Well, this is an important thing to have. This is untraceable. Anybody can get this kit right here. You don't have to go through a federal firearms license place. You can have it shipped right to your house.
This is what the traders have been trying to shut down.
Absolutely. So you basically have everything you need besides a lower receiver, because that's what's traceable, that's what's serialized, and that's what the federal government's after. But you can get this right here. Get your own lower receiver any way you want. There's different programs. All you got to do is your own research, and you can find out how to get a lower receiver so that you can put it on this. Maybe you already have a lower receiver from an AR from way back that you just don't quite use anymore. It's old, something like that. You can throw it on this. You basically have a brand new rifle, and you saved money by putting it together yourself and buying this kit right here, which is cheaper than the actual rifle.
And they've got the highest quality barrels, the highest quality triggers. We're not just saying that. Go look at the third-party reviews. Tell them about the new rifle they're producing that's getting amazing reviews. And then I just got one, this 308.
Yes, that is very...
Arcadius.
Arcadius. That's very exciting. They just came out with their own line of AR-10 platforms, which is basically an AR-15, but instead of it being a 5.56, it shoots a 308 round, which I know you personally like shooting a 308.
I like them both. And, I mean, just to be clear, they've always, for years, been making this for the big manufacturers, the high-end. They're just now not private labeling. They're putting out their own guns.
Yes. Well, the one they sent you, I'm actually jealous of, is a beautiful gun. It's set up and configured for long-range shooting, marksmanship-type things.
Just the scope alone is something to snuggle with.
Yeah, it's a Vortex 4x16 scope, which you can get a head down as well, their distributor. Things for people to remember is that if you want a 308, you don't have to get the 18-inch barrel. You don't have to get the 22-inch barrel. You don't have to get it set up for marksmanship. You can get one with a 16-inch barrel that's set up for more of an assault weapon type, you know, configuration. So anything you want, people, just call head down. You can get anything you want made there and any configuration you might want on your rifle. They're able to do that, and they have 100% perfect customer service ratings there.
Bottom line, it's not just firearms, a ton of accessories, very affordable, and it supports the InfoWar. If you're not shopping at hdfirearms.com, you're not helping the InfoWar. I mean, this is a win-win. Thank you all for your support. Check them out today. Thank you, Weldon. Alex Jones here, reporting from the capital city of Italy, Rome. This ancient city is so incredibly important to understand what's happening in modern times, because much of our political culture, but also economic culture, came out of the city of Rome, that had the largest world empire in history up until that time, except for Alexander the Great. And the Romans themselves had modeled much of what they did off of the Macedonian known world conqueror that came, of course, hundreds of years before, the legend of Romulus and Remus suckling from a she-wolf here at the center of the Seven Hills. What we do know is it was the Treaty of Rome in the late 1950s that founded the covert European Union that is now destroying what's left of national sovereignty and individual freedom. We have seen the private central banks install presidents in Italy, and presidents and leaders in places like Greece. Truly unprecedented. And as we watch the world economic collapse be engineered, InfoWars knew that it was key to travel to Spain, Italy, and other countries to see for ourselves exactly what is happening. We're producing a documentary out of this trip that'll air in about a month or so on InfoWars Nightly News. Rob Dew, InfoWars Nightly News Director, is here with us helping run camera. So is Buckley Hammond, and of course, myself. But you've got to get on the ground to experience it for yourself. Being in Spain, there were more foreigners than there were Spanish. There's just flotillas coming in from North Africa on a daily basis. Same thing with Italy. Just literally hundreds of thousands of illegal immigrants a year as Africa collapses, as the Middle East collapses, and much of that is because of Western policies that are deliberately destabilizing Africa and the Middle East so they can be more easily controlled for their raw resources. And then the people of the West end up paying for it when these immigrant populations come in. The globalists then put them on welfare and use them as a new political tool, giving them voting rights in many cases to then be an outside political force to checkmate any action to kick out the globalists that have economically conquered these countries. So here we are in the birthplace of what has become fascism worldwide. Here we are in Rome. and some of the leaders of Italy, and of course the mayor of Rome and others have said recently in the London Telegraph that they believe the city is on the verge of collapse. So we're going to be out investigating to see how serious the depression in Europe is. We're also going to be seeing if the unemployment is as bad as they say, upwards of 30%. It was 40% in Spain. We were in the Catalan area. We were in Barcelona, the wealthiest city in Spain, but still talking to the people off record, they were scared and said that things were not as good as it had used to be. And that was in the most wealthy sector of Spain that's been trying unsuccessfully to secede. But we saw literally tens of thousands, they were just on almost every doorstep and hanging off every balcony, of secession flags for the Catalonians wanting to leave Spain. And we know there's all sorts of moves in Italy trying to get out from underneath the European Union. That's why they're trying to use this crisis to bring in even more EU control and dissolve what local, regional, national sovereignty was left. So there's no check or no balance, no separation of powers like we have in the United States on the EU dictatorship that has been set up. But here we are, the place where Julius Caesar was stabbed to death after he brought his troops in from the north, crossing the Rubicon, becoming a dictator. Here we are in the place where Mussolini, the fascist leader, was hung up by his legs and basically spit on by tens of thousands. Here we are in the capital city of Italy, where so much of the fight for the globalist takeover is taking place. And we're going to be doing man-on-the-street interviews. We're going to be also traveling. I'm going to pick this out on a map, a random small town to go to in Italy, separate from Rome itself, to try to get a flavor of just exactly what's happening there. And so many people who are ignorant politically, not really our audience, but folks I see on YouTube, people commenting on InfoWars, say, you know, why do we care about Europe? Well, that's like saying, why do you care if the stock market crashes? Well, I don't own stock. I don't care. Well, if the stock market crashes, then most businesses will crash. Then you'll be laid off. Or if you own your own shop or business, people won't have money to come in and buy from it. I mean, I know real business owners, people in the real economy know this, but so many smart mouths out there say, why do we care if China collapses with the stock market? Why do we care if Europe collapses? There's kind of this sick idea that I've seen out there that when somebody else does bad, we do good. No, that's not how trade works, especially when we've been globalized. When another nation does bad, we do bad as well. And that's what Ron Paul always talks about. It's time to stop fighting. It's time to stop having this wartime-based economy and get onto a free market economy. But the globalists don't want that. They're on record wanting managed crony economies where they control who gets the business, they control who gets the contracts.
Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Vote for Jeb, or you're just f***ing stupid.
Fool me, we can't get fooled again.
Jakari Jackson here. Now, I've done a lot of reports about firearms, and a lot of things that we hear about is reasonable gun control. We need reasonable gun control, reasonable limits on our magazines, reasonable types of firearms, and we'll talk about all that here in a second. But now reasonable has gone to cartoon-level absurdity. As we see this, the hashtag to disarm the iPhone. This little revolver was just too much for some people to handle, and now they want to ban it. And if you look over here on this screen, Android also has gun emojis, but if you send somebody a revolver via your iPhone, they're going to get this little black powder pistol, which here in the state of Texas, it's 100% legal. And we also saw something our photographer pointed out. This is a tweet from Nick Moons, who called it back in 2013, wondering if the government was going to take away their gun emojis because it makes some people want to shoot up places. I'm sure there's a bit of sarcasm in there because I don't think anybody looks at a little gun emoji and goes on a shooting spree. But good luck to you, Nick Moons, for calling this thing way out in advance. Like I said, it's not so much the government behind this campaign, but I wouldn't be surprised if they did put some steam behind it. Now let's look at a thing that a little revolver can do. It can defend your family. As we see here, a woman shoots an intruder 5 times because he broke into her home. So she pulled out her .38 revolver in the state of Georgia and shot the perpetrator you see on your screen 5 times. And that brings up another issue when we talk about firearms, because guns have been so glamorized in the media. You watch, you know, Rambo or James Bond, and Bond pulls out a little micro pistol, shoots somebody, you know, 200 yards away, and the guy falls down. It doesn't really happen like that in real life. So you may need more than one or two shots in your pistol. You may need more than five shots in your rifle. And to anybody who says, well, I have no issue with revolvers, it's the AK-47s and the AR-15s that keep me awake at night. Let's take a look at last night's nightly news with Darren McBreen.
The place, and he successfully defended both his business and his life in the process. Rami Mirror, owner of a Milwaukee-based clothing store, posted video of the encounter to the company's Instagram account with a stark warning to any other potential burglars. Don't come to our establishment with guns or try breaking in our stores and expect less than us defending ourselves. We will protect our business and employees at any cost. And check this video out again. You can see in the video how the criminals used a car to smash into the doors so the robbers could get in, but they are quickly met with resistance. The owner managed to hit one of the guys as they ran the hell out of there. And they ran
out of there in a pretty big hurry. So again, that's why you may need something like an AR-15. The shop owner was able to engage the guys at a comfortable distance. He had a big open store and enough room to reach out and touch somebody. Because as formidable as something as a revolver can be, in a pressure situation, you may want something with a little more accuracy at that range, like a AR-15. And to anybody who's concerned, this is a empty revolver. There's nothing in it. So you can save your little Twitter comments. But as we come to a close, I just want to point out to people that when we talk about firearms, at least when we talk about AR-15s, you can look down here. This is the FBI crime statistics, and you see knives and cutting instruments. We look at 1,490 deaths from those back in 2013, and then we look at the rifle, which had 285 deaths, which is to say you are much more likely to be stabbed to death than you are to be shot with an AR-15 or AK-47. And also, to anybody who wants to ban the gun emoji, you might consider these things as well: the butcher knife, the bomb, the cigarette, and the needle. You can find more reports on Infowars.com.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
Hi, I'm Shane Steiner. A lot of you have been following my progress using Supermail Vitality. The last 19 weeks has been an incredible experience. I was feeling a little down and lethargic during the holidays, and none of the supplements that I was taking were doing any good. That's when my longtime friend from high school, Alex Jones, introduced me to Supermail Vitality. I was a little skeptical at first. Not only would I have the energy to work out and go to the gym, but it was actually the changes were happening to my body a lot more rapidly. My whole mood, my libido, everything had completely changed. The concentrated organic herbs, they stimulate your natural systems to produce the natural hormones that you need. I just really wanted to bulk up and hit it hard, and I went in for about the first 5 weeks and was lifting heavy weight and just really hitting it hard, and I gained 20 pounds of muscle immediately. Since that, I've decided I was gonna lose some weight and slim down. I just changed up my workout a little bit and 35 pounds came off. Folks, this is not a joke. This is not a gimmick, it's real. Supermail Vitality, available at InfowarsLife.com.
Introducing Secret 12, the new Infowars Life vitamin B12 formulation. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. That's why for real results, so many are having to turn to painful B12 injections, which are known to have higher absorption rates. Now, InfowarsLife.com is excited to announce that we can bring you our most bioactive, powerful form of B12 that has been developed with our exclusive perfected process. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin. Secret 12 is simply taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Secure your revolutionary Secret 12 formula right now at InfowarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139. Our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com.
Three members of the extensive Bin Laden family, Osama's stepmother, half-sister, and her husband, suspiciously died in a plane crash on Friday. The Saudi-owned Embraer Phenom 300 private jet crashed into a British car auction lot on the edge of the Blackbush Airport in Hampshire, England, wiping out roughly 30 cars and killing everyone on board, including the Jordanian pilot. A pilot who frequently uses the airstrip questions the probability of the crash. Simon Moores said a plane of that caliber would be equipped with top-of-the-range safety functions, which should have worked to prevent the crash. He explained that the airplane, which traveled to the UK from Milan, only needs around 800 meters to land, but overshot the Blackbush airstrip measuring 1,300 meters. Moores said, "Why? If the pilot thought his angle was completely wrong, which is what happened in this case, why didn't he power up the engines to simply go around and try again?" King Salman of Saudi Arabia offered his condolences to the Bin Laden family and then cut short his controversial planned 3-week vacation on the French Riviera as his entourage of 1,000 vacated the public beach they had sealed off, causing an uproar in France that produced a petition signed by 100,000 people against the closure of the public beach.
Rescue workers pushed people away from the scene.
We are walking back. The building is about to blow up.
Since the early days after the September 11th attacks, when the news emerged that most of the airline hijackers came from Saudi Arabia, dark allegations have lingered about official Saudi ties to the terrorists. Fueling the suspicions, 28 still classified pages in a congressional inquiry on 9/11 that raised questions about Saudi financial support to the hijackers and the United States prior to the attacks. Both the administrations of George W. Bush and Barack Obama have refused to declassify the pages on grounds of national security. But critics, including members of Congress who have read the pages in the tightly guarded underground room in the Capitol where they are held, say national security has nothing to do with it. U.S. officials, they charge, are trying to hide the double game that Saudi Arabia has long played with Washington as both a close ally and petri dish for the world's most toxic brand of Islamic extremism.
President Bush, he is the one that when they came out with the 9/11 report, the administration reviewed it, and the Bush administration said, "No, the 28 pages in this report must be classified." I have read the classified pages, and many of my colleagues have as well, the 28 pages. There is nothing, Alex, in here about national security. If it was, I would not be on your show. I would not introduce this resolution with two other members of the House. What we're asking people around this country, think about the pain of the 9/11 families, and think about you, the American citizen. Don't you have a right to know the truth about who was behind 9/11?
Back in 1988, Osama's older brother, Salam bin Laden, died in a plane crash in San Antonio, plummeting into power lines after the aircraft he was piloting tilted forward. Salam had been the patriarch of the bin Laden family empire after his father's death, and may have been too big an obstacle for Osama's future plans that would later become the catalyst the globalists required to slowly dissolve American liberties. John Bound for Infowars.com.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security while sticking our hands down on the pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch, the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the info war to the next level.
As a community moves towards despotism, respect is restricted to fewer people.
That's veteran Denver police officer Charles Jones IV smashing an unarmed suspect in the face 6 times.
Officers accused of using excessive force on a suspect and then trying to erase the evidence.
I'm observing what they're doing and they're arresting me. I don't understand what's going on.
A community rates low on an information scale when the press, radio, and other channels of communication are controlled by only a few people.
Does it raise ethical questions about the use of government money to produce stories about the government that wind up being aired with no disclosure that they were produced by the government?
How can you ask such a question?
What difference at this point does it make?
When a competent observer looks for signs of despotism in a community, he looks beyond fine words and noble phrases.
There are actions I have the legal authority to take as president that will help make our immigration system more fair and more just. Tonight, I'm announcing those actions.
What I say goes, see? I'm the law around here.
We came, we saw, we died.
Yes, in modern warfare, our military leaders are finding that words and ideas are highly effective weapons.
We just have to be repetitive about this. We need to do this every day of the week and just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
We are trained to deceive if we have to. You really don't have to trust me. You shouldn't trust me. In fact, by my actually participating in that, I will taint the news.
In communities of this kind, despotism stands a good chance.
The 9 most terrifying words in the English language are, I'm from the government and I'm here to help.
Okay, Ms. Youth, well, we're going to do everything we can to help you.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's the Alex Jones Show, because there is a war on for your mind.
Well, if you want to see the UN's climate agenda at work, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency is going to be spending $1.5 million of your taxpayer dollars on a stove intervention in Africa. That's right. Those pesky wood-burning stoves that humans have been using for centuries have now come under scrutiny due to the carbon emissions from when Africans cook. Some 200 houses in the Sahel region of Africa will be randomly selected. Some families will be given improved cook stoves, and then they're going to study and assess the use and behaviors of the emissions for the next year.
The EPA grant argues that this project is necessary because the population in this region is projected to continue to grow at alarming rates, which will result in ever-increasing emissions from cooking and lighting.
If everybody's raising living standards to the point where everybody's got a car and everybody's got air conditioning and everybody's got a big house, the planet will boil over.
The Obama administration kicked off a massive campaign today to cut carbon dioxide emissions. This climate campaign includes a trip to the Alaskan Arctic by President Barack Obama. He's going to call attention to the effects of global warming. Ironically, his trip will emit tons of carbon dioxide, 161 metric tons for just that one leg of the flight, or about 354,585 pounds of carbon dioxide. That's equivalent to what 22 homes emit from burning electricity every year, or the annual emissions from driving 33 cars, or 33 African families cooking for a year. Now, obviously, there are health risks associated with smoke inhalation that comes from cooking indoors, but there are several companies that are already actively working to improve the way cooking is done in the developing world. But just look at the hypocrisy of President Obama's unnecessary trip to the Arctic. Unless he is giving his speech on top of a melting ice cap, there is absolutely no reason for him to go there while he's lecturing the world on climate change. Throughout its 4.5 billion year lifespan, the Earth has gone through tremendous changes. Who knew we were just waiting for his Lord and Savior Barack Obama's climate plan to fix everything?
And our Lord and Savior, Barack Obama. Barack Obama.
In the past decade, we have witnessed unparalleled scientific discoveries in the area of health. But no one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. DNA Force is one of the most expensive formulas to produce. Some of the ingredients in DNA Force are $12,000 a kilogram. We are using the coveted, patented, only American source of PQQ, CoQ10, and more. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? Well, we're bringing you a total win-win. The ultimate value, cutting-edge, trailblazing game changer that also supports the Infowar. We have produced a limited run of DNA Force, and it will take up to 12 weeks to produce more once we sell out. Secure your DNA Force today at InfowarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. DNA Force. The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. For a limited time, get 25% off on this introductory offer. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. AncientDefense.com.
This is the heart of 1776. It wasn't one of the reasons that the war against King George began. It was the central, main, final reason at Lexington and Concord. And it wasn't one of the reasons there was a rebellion against the dictator Santa Anna, later thrown out in Mexico proper. It was the main central reason they met at Washington on the Brazos, where my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather Ayers helped kick the whole thing off to say, we're not turning our guns in, and we're not running, and we're not backing down. If you want them, come and take them.
That was just an excerpt from my Alamo speech back on October 20th, 2013 in San Antonio, Texas. They'd said that open carry was illegal, even though state law said we could. They had a phony local law that was trumped. Over 1,500 Americans, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, together, gave the first political speech that's been allowed, that everybody else except for Switzerland has been disarmed. And countries that are disarmed always devolve into tyrannies. So, you know what? If you don't like Second Amendment, get out of the country and stop throwing your guilt trips where you try to guilt us into turning our guns in so we can live in a hellhole like South Chicago, New York, or D.C. Go to those places to be fed on by predators. We don't want to be victims. Do you got it?
We want to interview the moms, the marching, what, Million Mom March or whatever they are. You know where they are? Down there, maybe?
We have no idea.
Roger that. We can't even find them. So we're going to go look for them and ask them a few questions about why they like gun control, why they like statistically more deaths, and why they like Mexico. So, but we're trying. We can't even find them anywhere.
Are you the head of the local organization?
No, I'm not.
I'm the head of the local.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Alex Jones.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good, good, good. Yeah. So tell us about what you're doing here today.
Well, I would prefer to have just a moment to talk to you off camera before we, you know, you bring your cameras in to our event. Is that okay?
Well, he's just right there.
No, I understand that.
It's just First Amendment. You're a public group. We're just wondering.
I thought this was to raise awareness.
If crime rates have dropped 49% since 1992 because of gun ownership increasing, why would we want to be like Mexico, where they've taken all the guns, they have the highest crime rate in the world, or Chicago?
Okay, I'm not going to stand here and be bullied by you into having a conversation that is not...
Rammed into me.
I know I came over to ask you to please...
Wow, you just... That's like assault.
Yeah,
isn't this a public event?
Why did you touch me?
Because I don't like you.
You don't like me?
No.
Why?
Why did you leave her alone? We're having a peaceful time here.
Well, I just don't want anybody to touch me. You already slammed into me. You're not going to touch me, are you, sir?
Go away. We don't want you here. We don't want you.
What's wrong? We were so friendly.
What public event is this if you don't want any exposure?
We thought you wanted press. We're press. We're here to be friends.
Okay, rowdy go.
It went really well. We're going to have more of them. We're going to take our civil rights back.
You're taking your civil rights?
Just like in 1776.
Who took your civil rights?
They've taken the guns in Chicago, New York, D.C.
They're taking your guns?
Feinstein says the goal is to ban all the guns. It says right here.
Nobody's trying to take your toys.
They haven't taken
ban
the guns.
Assault weapons.
They're not trying.
Says right here.
Wait.
That's all semiotic.
Shut up and let me talk.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
You are not saying that correctly. We want to ban. She wants to ban assault
You're
weapons
she.
In the Diane Feinstein. You're the one that brought her up.
But Bloomberg wants a total ban.
Wait. But they don't want to confiscate people that are.
Did they confiscate guns in New Orleans?
They say there are no orders to use force, just strong persuasion. Sometimes entering open houses with guns drawn. And instructions to disarm anyone inside.
You say guns will be taken?
No one will be able to be armed. We will take all weapons.
Have they banned the guns in Chicago and New York and D.C.?
No, they have not.
Mayor Bloomberg, how you doing? Jason, I grew up in Brooklyn. In the spirit of gun control, will you disarm your entire security team?
You will get right back to you.
You'll get back to me?
They have not banned the guns. You do not want our guns. That's well, good.
We want your guns.
Good.
We don't want you here.
Santa Ana wanted the guns.
In reality, statistics, you're very upset. We're very sorry that we brought facts and reality.
What about the 49% drop in violent crime since 1992 because of gun ownership going up? I'm a libertarian. Shake my hand. Come on. Want a hug? How about a hug? How about a hug? Come on. Come on, I support. Yeah, here.
We're being nice about this whole thing.
Yeah, how about be friends? Here. What's your name?
Matt.
Matt.
Yeah.
Matt, listen, you know Hitler was for gun control.
It's going to be 1776 again, isn't it?
Well, we're trying to avert. We're trying to avert
once,
1776.
Once you bring up Hitler, you're obviously not serious about the conversation.
Oh, no, but Lenin and Stalin and Mao.
Stalin, Hitler. It's just,
Santa Ana, they all came to take the guns. Governments don't try to take the guns. Well, here's like people that like gun control ban them all in like Chicago, New York, and D.C. So why wouldn't we think that there's really a plan to register them and take them if they've taken them other places? Real question.
Why do you assume I'm for that?
No, but I'm saying the bills they're trying to move forward. The mayor pro tem of Austin said once we register your guns, we will confiscate them.
That there is no gun ban currently, but because of the work that we're doing here today, we will make your sign legitimate shortly. So you hang on to that.
You may be one of the more moderate members, but that's the point. It says ban assault weapons, which is even semi-automatic, and ammunition magazines that hold more than 10 rounds. This is a Bloomberg. You guys don't take money from Bloomberg. No money from Bloomberg.
Your rally that you think was so successful, it's so well accepted in Texas, it's not accepted nationwide.
And that'll be used to get guns other places. I know, but here's the deal. We are desensitizing people, just like you guys say. The Attorney General said we've got to brainwash people that guns can't even be seen.
One thing that I think is clear with young people and with adults as well is that we just have to be repetitive about this. It's not enough to simply have a catchy ad on a Monday and then only do it every Monday. We need to do this every day of the week and just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
So we're not brainwashing, we're reversing. We're openly saying, look, we have a right to own guns.
I don't want people walking around with assault rifles on their backs, walking into Walmart, Starbucks. We don't need
that. But you like cops with guns everywhere.
Yes, I want the cops to have guns.
Here's the deal,
yes.
We're going to have the guns everywhere, and if you guys try to take them, 1776.
You know what a gun grab is? It's something that nobody in this country wants.
If I could have gotten 51 votes in the Senate of the United States for an outright ban, picking up every one of them, Mr. and Mrs. America, turn them all in, I would have done it.
A gun grab is something that nobody in this country
wants.
Well,
sir, all I can say is you are really getting in my space, like your wife came over and pushed up against me.
Why don't you back up?
No, I'm not going to back up. Good. You're the one got my space.
You know
look
what?
At this. Look at this guy.
Stop.
All right, go ahead.
Stop.
Stop. Listen, I don't want to beat an old guy up, so don't touch me, all right?
This guy could take you out in a heartbeat.
I bet he could. I'm not violent.
Why do you think it's okay to sell a gun to someone that you don't know that's not been through a background check?
Should we have a background check for bathtubs every time we take a bath?
We should have a background check for guns.
Should we have a background check for knives?
You don't believe in a background check?
No. Have you heard about
We all know it's a registration. We have your documents.
Have you read the bill 1565 that says it's against the law to keep a registration and it's a $15,000 fine?
But they've caught them keeping it.
Sell a gun?
They've caught them keeping it.
What do you think about knives?
I
mean, there's
Ronnie,
a knife assault.
You're giving them what they want. Don't do it anymore.
Listen, don't listen to the facts. Don't listen to the statistics. Just yell at us and call us names. That is the only thing that works.
Did you know assault rifles are used in 2% of crimes?
I know an assault rifle was used to murder my daughter in Aurora. I know that.
Well, I'm sorry that...
Yeah, you're sorry.
I didn't hurt your daughter. I mean, that's the big issue is there's probably five people here against the guns, and they're claiming it's probably true. There's a guy had a lot of sadness in his eyes, that it's his loved one that was lost at Aurora. And that's basically our fault. And the media is preying on these victims of gun control and gun-free zones like movie theaters, schools, and military bases, where the SWAT team was ordered to stand down at the Naval Yard. They are preying on us. And they're preying on people that have had loved ones that are lost in our pain to then blame others that have the right to self-defense, when overall in the aggregate, guns are saving more lives than they're losing by 40%+ to 1. If you look at just 20 years ago, it was 20 plus times a gun was used to stop crime or murder. Now it's 40 plus times on average. And so I'm like, here's the average. I'm sorry bad stuff happens. It's like cars. God forbid my daughter die in a car wreck. I'm not going to then go out if it's a drunk driver that did it. I'm going to blame him. I'm not going to blame Ford or Chevy. These people don't get they've lost. We know who they are. We're the liberals. Thomas Jefferson's a liberal.
And that's it for our show tonight. If you guys just saw that video of Alex at the Alamo, you saw the Come and Take It flag, and we have that right here in the InfoWars shop. We also have the t-shirts, the Molon Labe, the whole nine yards for you right there at the InfoWars shop. And also, you can stop by prisonplanet.tv, get yourself a free trial. You can see the Alex Jones Show, the nightly news, the special reports, the rants, all right there at PPTV. And finally, don't forget the Alex Jones channel on YouTube, where you can see all the special reports right there, what you see. It's an exclusive report for YouTube, for our YouTube listeners, and everybody who we reach on that platform. Well, I'm Jakari Jackson reporting to you from the InfoWars Command Center, and we'll see you again tomorrow night.
Brain Force is here. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been on this the last few months. You probably noticed I've been more crazed, more focused, less brain fog, more energy, more special reports. And it's because of Brain Force.
We kept changing this formula over and over and over again until it became sort of a grand puzzle. For example, the L-theanine inside of it, that is activated by the different compounds in the yerba mate that we put inside of it as well. This just increases the compounds you already have.
This is what you're actually designed to run on.
Exactly.
It's kind of like a car will run on one form of junkie gas, but it runs really good on what it's designed for.
And that's the principle of InfoWars Life, as far as I understand, that you've always had, is that it's not about synthetic chemicals and forcing actions. It's about letting your body do its own thing and giving your body the tools it needs to create these different compounds that are super valuable and super beneficial.
You will find Brain Force and other game-changing products at InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
You are watching the InfoWars Nightly News, which airs 7 p.m. Central at InfoWarsNews.com. And your support is helping us defend liberty worldwide.